The 40-year-old Radio 5 Live newsreader, who was first diagnosed with breast cancer in November 2016, recalled the devastating moment she had received the news her condition was incurable. Writing on her blog, Big C, Little Me, she explained how she had been out for the day with her son Fred and some of his friends when she received the phone call. My heart raced as I answered it, knowing a phone call did not bode well, she wrote. Then came the words, I am so sorry, it's bad news. The biopsies have come back showing the same cancer is back and is in the skin. I watched my little Fred innocently playing away in a tire in the barn and my heart broke for him, Rachael said. I scooped him up and dashed home and then had to break Steve's heart with the news that my cancer was now metastatic and therefore incurable. I feel an odd sense of pride that I am one of fewer than 150 people worldwide who will test it. Rachael Bland with the cancer not responding well to chemotherapy, Rachael was informed her best chance was treatment with a novel agent. She is now part of a clinical trial for a new immunotherapy treatment. Now I have turned lab rat, she said. I am in the hands of the incredible team on the Christie Clinical Trials Unit. They work at the very cutting edge of cancer treatment, looking to make those little discoveries about new drugs that may lead the way forward in cancer treatment for the future. Speaking about the condition of her cancer, Rachael revealed, I have extensive skin metastases in my left breast and chest, mets to the nodes above the collarbone on the left side. I have a tumor in my liver and a couple of suspicious spots on my spine. I also have a small collection of fluid on the outside of my right lung, called a pleural effusion, which is indicative of some cancer starting to lurk there. So that's skin, nodes, liver, bones, lung. I think even the unscientific amongst you can do the math on that one. However, she shared her positivity going forward, opening up about her pride in being part of the clinical trial. It is a phase 1b trial, so very early in the process, and I feel an odd sense of pride that I am one of fewer than 150 people worldwide who will test it, she said. If it doesn't help me, then I hope the data I provide will at some point in the future help others in the same position. If the treatment doesn't help, there are others she can go on to try. I am 5 days into a strict protocol of infusions and tablet taking, Rachael wrote. I am being closely monitored for any side effects. I feel a bit like a grenade with a pin out, she admitted. Her next scan is in 6 weeks, and if the cancer has shrunk or is stable, she will stay on the trial. Just waiting for some odd sensations to appear. If it has grown by more than 20%, then Rachael says she will cut her losses and try the next one. We are waiting and hoping. Whatever greater power you believe in, send us your collective prayers, she concluded.